Hello, hello everyone. So excited to be here. I'm excited to get this party started. I love this time of year. Stamptember is Christmas for card makers. While everyone is sort of coming in, I thought I would go ahead and give you just kind of the rundown on Stamptember, how it works. Stamptember is a month-long stamp party over at SimusStamp.com. It's just celebrating the love of stamping, and it started out like a really small little celebration, and it's grown over the years. This is the 11th year of Stamptember as Simus Says Stamp, and every year it gets better and better. So I saw people in the comments asking about if the entire release is available now or not. It's the exact same as it has been in previous years, in that the Simon brand has a big release that comes out on the 1st of September, which technically it is the 1st of September now in Ohio, where Simon is based. Now, I'm 2 hours behind in Utah, so it's 10 p.m. here, but over in Ohio, it is September 1st, so Stamptember has begun. And all of the release from the Simon brand is available now. In fact, if you want to, you can refresh this video, and I have the entire release linked down below in the video description. Or there's just a link, you can just go straight to Simon and see it all there. But I have everything listed down below in the order that I will be showing them tonight. And I hope that makes it easier for you guys to kind of shop for what catches your eye. So, got some people in the comments. Yay! Okay, so the other part of the Stamptember release that people want to know about are the collaboration sets with other stamp companies. In the past, Simon has released those one by one throughout the month, and they will be doing that again this year. So, I'm not sure exactly when they'll start. It's usually a few days into the month. So watch for those on the Simus's Stamp blog. And let me tell you, I have the entire release, like all of them, over there. And they're amazing. You're going to love them. So many fun, creative images and greetings. And I really think all of the companies really knocked it out of the park. Tonight, though, we are focusing on the Simon release. And I've got quite a few things that I designed that were included in this release as well. So we're going to get right into it. And by the way, yes, I am wearing pajamas because this is 10 p.m. This is late for me. This is my pajama party. Hair is up, and I'm taking my makeup off and going to bed as soon as this is done. So, anyway, okay, so overhead, we've got here, got my mouse here so I can share images. We're gonna jump right into the stamps. So, the first stamp set is Slimline Greetings. These greetings are super lengthy for your slimline cards. So, I don't know about you, but with the slimline kind of trend that we've had over the last little bit, I've struggled finding greetings that are long enough to go on card. So, I don't recall who designed this one specifically, but I really do love how everything is overlapped on these little outline ones. I think it looks so fantastic. So, okay. Oh, thank you, Dana. Dana says my PJs are dope. I mean, it's so funny. I'll put myself in the top corner so you guys can see me talking at you. So this is Slimline Greetings. I'm gonna try to go through this fairly quickly, just because there's so many. There are so many. Okay, the next stamp set is this one called I Am With You. Isn't that so cute? It has the best sentiments and greetings. Love that. It's so great. And I love the handwritten greetings. I think they look fantastic. I believe the stamp set was done by Liz from Encourage Co. Over at Instagram. She's fantastic. She's done a lot of stamp sets for Simon in the past. This next one, let's see here, is called Mix and Match Circles. This is going to make the coolest, like, mod patterns. I'm so excited about this. I love it. I used to have a stamp set like this probably back in 2005, 2006. I had like kind of like similar imagery. I used the cramp out of that stamp set. And it was one of my very first clear stamp sets as well. I can't remember what the company was. They're long gone now, but it was a really good stamp set. So once again, this is Mix and Match Circles. This next one is so dang cute. It's called Paper Hug. Isn't this adorable? Look how cute. It is so cute. Now there are coordinating dies for this, but I do not have them personally. So, but it cuts out the big imagery and like these down here as well. Let me zoom out a little bit. You can see the full stamp set all at once. Isn't that so cute? Yeah, some of you have already ordered stuff. Like if you were on the VIP email list for Simon, so let us know in the chat. What did you order? We want to know what you got. Okay, so this is Paper Hug. This next set is really interesting and fun. It's called Banner Greetings, and it comes with this acetate template. So it has this little sheet in here, and you notice it can, let me see if I can find, like this piece right here goes over that banner. So what you can do is take these greetings that are in a straight line and you can stick it to the acetate and get it in the exact curvature you need. And then you can put it on your Misti. Such a cool idea. This was, this idea kind of came about when we were brainstorming this release, and Nina Marie did the stamp set, I believe. And we had this idea of including like a little guide or a template to do all of the, all the little banners. I think it's just so fun. So I believe, I mean, I asked Nina tonight, I asked her, does this come with the stamp set? And she said, yes, it does. There are dies that go with it. I don't have the dies though. So, but there are dies that will cut out all the banners. So amazing. Okay. This next one is one of mine. Recognize my handwriting. This one is Sympathy Greetings Mix. Such a good mix of greetings. Let me get this closer for you guys, because there's some smaller ones in here, so you want to see this a little up close. You know, I just found that I had occasions for sympathy cards, sadly, and I wanted just one big stamp set that was going to have, you know, was going to cover all my bases. So here we go. This is Sympathy Greetings Mix. All right, here's another one of mine. Some of you who follow me on Instagram might recognize a couple of these. This one in particular, this is one that I posted on Instagram, and there were multiple people who said, I want a stamp of that. And you know, it's such a kind of beefy greeting. It needed to be really big. So this is XL Greetings. And the best part about it, there are matching dies. There are coordinating dies that you can purchase separately or as a set. So you can get all of these. It's amazing. I love the Sending Sunshine and the Miss You. I think this is going to get a lot of use in my craft room. I love this. All right, moving on. This is called Boo Crew. Okay, this is adorable. Okay, look at all these cute images. They're so cute. And I love the Halloween with the candy corn. So cute. The bat down at the bottom with the different sizes of pumpkins, spiders, some really great smaller greetings to go when you make a big, huge, you know, scene of all these people. And this one does have a coordinating die set as well that you can purchase separately. So it's a great Halloween set. I don't make a lot of Halloween cards, but I do love making Halloween cards, but I don't send them. Like I don't have use for them, but I love the imagery. It's so cute. Okay, here's one that I did called, let's see, Prismatic Snowflakes. They kind of all look like little gems. That's kind of like the look I was going for, like really three-dimensional gems. So you guys know I love my snowflakes. I love snowflakes. And I love doing different styles of snowflakes. I love it so much. So once again, this is Prismatic Snowflakes. It's a 4x6 set. All right, next up, let's see, we have Laugh in Flowers. I love these like dandelions. They're so cute. I love it. And I like the font choice and the greetings on this one. Laugh in Flowers. It's for this sentiment down here. This is The Earth Laughs in Flowers from Emerson. So nice. All right, this next set has a story behind it. This set of products. This is one that I did. I'm going to zoom in for you because you guys need to see these greetings. The stamp set is called Tiny Words Support. And then this one is You Matter. And I designed this stamp set and die at the beginning of June. When we were all having a lot of, we were all in the feels, we were all in our emotions. And I just wanted to let the people in my life know that they matter. No matter where they come from, the color of their skin, their sexual orientation, what country they're from, all walks of life, they matter to me. And I wanted to do some greetings that said that. And so this set of greetings covers a lot of different bases for anyone who needs support. And then there's a die that, you know, if you can see that backwards, it says You Matter. And there's a shadow for it too. But I've never cried while designing stamp sets before, but I was just an emotional wreck during this entire thing because to like think about the occasions when I would need to send greetings such as this, it really got me in my feels. So, yeah. Anyway, this is a really important set to me. I've been waiting for it to come out. I'm so excited. Once again, this is Tiny Words Support and then the You Matter Die. I love it. I love it so much. I can't wait to use it. All right, I'm gonna zoom out because the next stamp set's real big. So I'm zooming out. Okay. All right, this next one is called What a Good Sport Outdoors. There's quite a few sports items in this release, which I think a lot of you guys are going to love, especially if you've got kids in sports or if you're a sports fanatic yourself. These are all really like punny little sayings. And there's an additional stamp set that I don't have called What a Good Sport Fall Winter that has a similar setup. So I'll link that down below, but I don't have that particular stamp set. So, and this does have some coordinating dies that you can buy. So this is a great little stamp set. All right, moving on. The next stamp set is called Because of You. Let me hold this up a little closer so you can see all of these. Such great greetings, right? I love this. Sometimes you just need greetings like this to send to people that are special to you. Love that. So this is Because of You. And then this next stamp set is so dang cute. I believe Nina Marie Trapani did this one. This one is called Pumpkin Spice Season. And it just has these cool little images. So fall, so autumn. Love it. There is a coordinating die for this, but I don't have it. But there is one. Alrighty. Moving on, this is Slimline Scene Builder Christmas. Look how great these are. Really large images, so you can put them on your slimline cards. Let me zoom out even more. So you can see, this can go on a slimline card. And you have this two separate pieces. You've got the ground right here, and then you have the sky with snow falling. And then you also can build, you know, put ornaments or snow on the trees. So brilliant. Sherry Carroll did this stamp set. She did a great job. I love this one. And there are dies that coordinate with it that cut out the trees. I think it might even cut out the ground section so you can like layer it, you know, give it some dimension. All right. This next one is called Good Vibes. I love this. I love big, huge images like this. And you can stamp the individual sections on this like gem image right here. You can do a main like solid and then do these other shapes to fill it in. So fun. So once again, this one is called Good Vibes. All right, now we're into the background stamps. There are so many good background stamps. You're gonna die. Okay, so this one is Damask or Damask. I always say it incorrectly. It should be Damask. Love this one. This is a really good staple, good like textured background. It's a good one. All right, this one's perfect for fall. Sunflower background. I love sunflowers, and these are really, really intricate with all the little individual little dots on the inside or the little circles. I think it's so fun. So this is sunflower background. This one's gonna be so fun to color. This one is hexagon tile background. Look at that pattern, isn't that fun? It's gonna be so fun. I love it, love it so much. Hexagon tile. This one is lantern pattern. Also amazing to color. Love this. All right. And then this one is, let's see, it is called Old Letter 1878. Such a cool texture for like the background of something. I think it's going to look amazing. And I love the like the very vintage handwriting. I love stuff like this. It's beautiful. This next one's going to become a staple in my crafting. I already know. This is wood planks. I love wood grain like this. Can you imagine like using like craft cardstock and then stamping this in like a dark brown ink? I think that would be amazing. Hold on. I got to move these stamps out of the way because it's blocking a lot of light. Okay. Where are these going to go? I'm running out of space in my craft room. Okay. All right. So there's wood planks. The next one is circle pattern. I love stuff like this. You can color in the individual circles. You can blend over the top. I think it's going to be great. Someone's saying it, something looks like pumpkins. I get the comments a little bit later than you guys say them, so I'm not sure what it was referring to. Oh, maybe the sunflower. Anyway, so this is circle pattern. And then this is one that I did called fractured. And I remember as a kid, I would do like line drawings like this all the time and then color the little individual segments. So great. So I can't wait to paint this. I think it's going to be really fun. Okay, now we're going to go into stencils. So I'm going to put down some solid paper so we can see the stencils. And I also have some images on screen so you can kind of see what they look like. So this one is called Game Day Patterns. It looks like this. In fact, maybe I'll just kind of come off to the side here. So this is what Game Day Patterns looks like. I'm not big in sports, so I have no idea what this means. But yes, this is Game Day Patterns. All right. The next one is this one right here. Maybe I won't take him out of the packaging because you can see it up in the top corner. But this one is called Game Day Playbook. Actually, I will take it out. You guys need to see it. So there you go. That's what that looks like. Isn't that a fun stencil? I think it'll be so fun for all those sports stamp sets. All right. Okay, we've got some really big stencils. I'm super excited about these. This is bubble wrap, and it is a 6x9 stencil. Sime's never done stencils this big, and it's specifically so you can use it on a 5x7 card or on a slimline card because it's 9 inches tall. Brilliant. Love that. We've got a few different stencils that are this size. All right. The next one is a classic favorite, large falling snow. We've taken the falling snow stencil and made it super big. Isn't that awesome? I did the falling snow stencil, I think back in 2013, 7 years ago. And to this day, it is one of the top selling products that I've ever done anyway. And people love the falling snow. It's so great. I love it. So this is a 6x9 stencil. It's going to be great. I'm so excited that, you know, it's nice and large and I can put on my 5x7 envelopes. Here's another 6x9 called Floating Leaves. And I love this one. Let me get it open for you. So floating leaves. Isn't that a great pattern? Love that. My friend Lisa, Game Day Patterns or alien script? You decide. That's so funny. Very true also. Okay, so this is floating leaves. And then here's one that I did, and it is called Autumn Splendor. It's a nice, dainty little stencil, so you'll probably want to get some pixie spray to use with this one, but it's got some autumn leaves, berries. It could go like autumn, or it could go Christmas. I think you could definitely go Christmas with this. All right. Okay, so now we're going to get into the dyes. So let's see, I'm gonna zoom in a little bit because I have to answer a question about this specific dye that's coming up first. All right, this is Sending Smiles Words. Now some of you will recognize this because it was a dye included in the most recent card kit from Simon. The dye that's in that kit is out of stock currently. It's on reserve, you can order it, and then it will be shipped to you when it's back in stock. But this is like a pared down version of that. The one that's out of stock also has the shadow, like the outer shape for the die. This one is just the words, same size and everything. It's just the words. And it's also a little bit cheaper because you don't have that additional die. So if you're not one that really uses like the shadow on the outside of your words, this would be the one for you. So this is Sending Smiles Words. All right. Next up, we have Happy Birthday Brush Script. This is one that I did. In fact, I believe this Happy Birthday is included on a stamp set that we've previously released, but I really wanted it as a die. I thought it'd be awesome. So Happy Birthday Brush Script. All right. Next one is Large Outline Spooky. This is similar to the Large Outline Thanks that we did a long time ago. Well, not that long ago, within the last year. And so it cuts the outer box, it cuts the really thin outline of the letters, and then also the interior of the letters. So you have a lot of different things you can do with this particular die. All right, next up we have Outline Halloween. So cute. I love how like wonky and playful it is. I think it's so cute. So Outline Halloween, you've got the outline letters, and you've also got the shadow or the halo. Okay, this next one is Best Day Ever. Sorry, it's upside down in my die packaging, but it's reversed. You can't really tell what it is anyway. But this is Best Day Ever. This is one with my lettering. So love this one. Best Day Ever. This next one's a good staple. Nested ovals, right? We need some like nested ovals. And I like that these don't get really pointy on the ends as they get smaller. Sometimes with ovals and nesting oval dies, as they get smaller, they start to get a little pointy on the ends. I like that these are nice and round. So nested ovals. Oh, I forgot to switch. There we go. Nested ovals. All right, this next one is geometric builder circles. I believe this is one that Laura Basson put together. She does a lot of like paper piecing with this, and I love when she does. So I'm excited to use these. Aren't these so fun? You can cut out a bunch of different cardstock colors and piece them back together, and they're perfectly sized because you've cut them out with your die cutting machine. Looks awesome. So this one is geometric builder circles. Alrighty, this next one along those same lines is geometric builder squares. So you have all those designs. I cannot wait to use these. They're going to be so fun. Awesome. Love these. All right, we've got some more slimline dies. This one is Slimline Marquee. So it says keep shining, and it's got like the dots all around the outer edge. So fun. You get three borders and then the words on the inside. This next one is a Slimline Scallop Frame. And this one says happy birthday. It's got a little happy birthday inside. You get two scallop frames and then the happy birthday. Alrighty. Moving along. This is Slimline Borders and Edges. Look how great this is. You've got these really cool, like, intricate edges, zigzag, or like pinking shears, kind of like a rainbow scallop. Then you've got like a regular scallop. It's great borders. And they're all long enough for a slimline card. All right, there's the graphic for that one. Forgot to switch. Another staple. This is slimline nested rectangles. Perfect for all your slimline cards if you're trying to get the perfect layers on your slimline card. This next one is really, really cool. Detail ringlet plate. Let me show you this actual plate. It's really, really cool. Let me get it out of the packaging. It cuts a bunch of little dots. Like it pierces all the little areas. Such a fun die. I think that's gonna get a lot of use out of it. I even have my label for when I put it in my storage pocket. I haven't had a chance to do that yet. All right, next one is etched laurel leaves. Let me show you the actual size of these. Pretty good size, right? That's a pretty good size. All right, don't want to lose my label. Put that back in. Next we have etched eucalyptus wreath. So it's a pretty good size. Let me show you on like an A2 card. This is an old A2 card, and that's how big the die is. It's a pretty good size. Okay, moving along. Next we have engraved feather. It's one big feather. Let me show you. There you go. In my hand, you can see how big that is. Isn't that pretty? Love that. All right. Tender leaves. I think these are a little bit smaller. Well, they're not too small. They're still pretty good size. Those cute. Love those. All righty. And then detail elm leaves. Oh, skipping ahead. I'm a one-woman show over here, guys. Sometimes I forget to change the images. Okay, so once again, this is detail elm leaves. Love that. All right, this one's interesting. This is one that I designed a while back, and I'm so glad it's finally being released. This is the box and ribbon gift card. So let me zoom out so you can see the whole entire die. This is what the whole die looks like. It's one big thing. It cuts out the card, and there's this secondary image. You can kind of see up in the top corner up here. I have the graphic that shows you. When you put the entire thing together, it still fits inside an A2 envelope. So you can put all the ribbon on the greeting card or just use it by itself. The actual note card, put the greeting card in between the slots, and then you have a really fun, like kind of like gift box. I think it's gonna be great for birthdays, for Christmas, for just about anything that you would have a gift card for. All right, this next one is called Latte Gift Card Slider. Now, I don't have an image of this one to show you guys, but it's really cool. This interior piece right here has kind of like the whip on the top, slides down into the mug, and you can pull it out, and then you'll have the gift card inside. Such a fun idea. It's going to be really cute. All right. This one I don't have, but it's Giant Hugs card wrap. It cuts like really big hands. You could do high fives. You could do, hugging stuff. I think it could be really, really cool. Okay. So now we're going to get into all of the products from CZ Design. And this first one is Spooky. It's her, I love the font she chooses for these. But you have the actual word Spooky and then the outline. So cool. Alrighty. Next up from Kathy, we have Batty. So you get two bats. There's the smaller one that has the eyes, but it perfectly nest inside the larger one that does not have eyes. So kind of a fun idea. So you could have more plain bat, or you can have the one that's a little more playful with the little eyes. All right. Next one is ghost in a circle. This is similar to Kathy's. I think it was like deer in a circle from last year. So cute. I love this little friendly little ghost face. He's so cute. We should name him Casper. All right. So let's see. Turn that off because we've got some stamps from Kathy. This is Chunky Christmas. Love these. I love her really clean graphic style. It's so fun. All right. And then she's done a Halloween set called Halloween People. I'm not sure why it's people. Oh, Halloween People are my people. That's where it comes from. There is a coordinating die set for that. So this is Halloween People. Look at those fun greetings. Let's party. And by party, I mean eat candy corn and watch scary movies in our costumes. I love that. I want to Halloween with you. Love that. All right. Another one from Kathy from CZ Design is Clean Line Gratitude. How great are these? She always has like a, she does a whole gratitude project, like an album every November. And this is one that she specifically made as a supplement to her project kit, or like what she works on. Love it. Yeah, CZ is so original. I love her. And I love her greeting. She's just delightful. And this one does have dies that go with it too, to cut out all the big words. All right. This is from CZ's Design again. This is a background stamp. This is Deco Squares. And she actually has a stencil. I'll show you in a minute, a stencil with a similar design. So this is Deco Squares background. All right, and then here's a let's see, Just Batty stencil. I don't have an image of this one, so you can see it right here. Isn't that cute? Makes me want to do like a Batman something or other. I have Batman postage stamps, so I might have to use this to make a Batman themed envelope. Wouldn't that be cute? Okay, so then also from Kathy is Simple Patterns Trio stencils. And this is kind of cool because it's exactly an A2 size for your card front, and it's centered right there. So you can get these centered perfectly in your card. So there's some diagonal stripes, some horizontal stripes, and then polka dots. Aren't those great? She's thought of everything. All right, and what I mentioned before is her Deco Squares. And here's the stencil. Let me get this out so you can see it better. There is the stencil. So Deco Squares stencil. All right, the last few things for Kathy's portion of the release. She's got a bunch of these reverse sentiment strips. So this is the reverse Christmas. So there's two sheets of each one of these. I love these reverse ones. Sometimes it's hard to get a really bright white sentiment on black cardstock, and so these just look fantastic. Love these. So a bunch of fun Christmas greetings from Kathy. All right, she's also done one for Halloween. So it's reverse sentiment strips Halloween, and once again, it's two designs, two of each. I love that. So cute. And I like that, you know, because like I said, I love Halloween imagery, but I don't make very many Halloween cards. So sometimes I don't want a whole stamp set for it. I just want to use something like this. So this is great. All right. And then she has a third one for birthday. And once again, two each of these designs. Love this. So great. All right. Okay. So from Susie Plantemur, we have a new set of coloring cards. This is even more birthday cards, and guess what they called it. And look how cute these are, because you get, I think you get three of each design. So there's some cute little birthday dogs. Of course, there's a birthday cat. I mean, it has to be equal. on the sun. It's your birthday. These will be great card fronts. Some birthday cakes. Happy birthday. I love all this with those smiley faces. And then a bouquet of flowers. How cute is that? All right. Next up, we have some, these are thanks sentiment strips, and there's two different packs. There's a thanks multicolor pack, and then there's white. So you have the two, actually I think it's all, yeah, they're all, you have four of the same design, with the white. And then with the multicolor, you're getting, I think there are six sheets in here. Nope, five. Nope, there is six. There's a pink one hiding. But these really cool pastel colors. I think that's so fun. So there's a multicolor pack of thanks sentiment strips, and then there's the all white. Alrighty. We're nearing the end here. We're almost done. How many minutes in are we? Let's see. We're about 35 minutes in. This is great. This is great. Okay, there's two packs of sequins. There's holographic rainbows. How cute are those, right? Such a fun pack. And then sea glass. So two different sequin packs you can choose from. All right. And then let's see here. Da, da, da. We're going into envelopes. And Simon has released a bunch of slimline envelope colors. This is Blue Lagoon, this top one. And then Violet Blue, which is kind of like, it's a really bluish purple, which is why it's called Violet Blue, or Blue Violet, I'm sorry. And then Cotton Candy, which is a nice pink, and then Orange. So all of these are slimline envelopes with the flap on the short end. And like all the other Simon envelopes, it does have their release paper, so it's self-adhering. Love those. All right, and there are a couple packs of items that I do not have. So let me see here. There's a pack of 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 card fronts in all the different Simon's stamp cardstock colors. It's a great pack. And then there's also one of the 120-pound white cardstock. And you get a bunch of those that are all card front size. So that's fantastic. All right, and the last few items I'm going to show you are these acetate sheets. Let me see here. I probably should have grabbed the images for these because they're hard to see in the packs. I'll just open them up. Which is really irritating live. Sorry for the sound, guys. All right, so this is a set where it's hands. It's making like a little heart shape. All of these are, you can use them as black, or you can use any of your foiling methods. So you can run this through a laminating machine or through a foil machine and put foil on top of these. So then you've got those, and you've got like the larger hands. Such a fun idea. All right, and that one is called Hold My Hand. This next set, I believe, is called Thanks and Leaves. Not sure why it's called Thanks. I think it's because the stamp set this is based off of was called Thanks and Leaves. But you get four of the same. And it has leaves going around the outside edge. So cool. So that's Thanks and Leaves acetate sheets. This next one I'm so excited about. I know I'm going to use in my holiday card series, or I want to. Just getting it open. This one is called Mod Trees. How fun is that? This is based off a background stamp that was released, I think, last year. So Mod Trees. Yes, you can foil all of these. How fun. Make sure you head over to the Simon store and look at these acetate sheets, because there are example images of cards that were made by Simon designers. And Sherry Carroll has some beautiful examples of these with foiling. Okay, here's this one. This is, and I think there's, yeah, there's different designs. They're not all the same. But this is Tumbling Leaves. It's based on the Tumbling Leaves stencil that came out, I think, last year. Really popular stencil. Love these. Can't wait to use them. So I've got like 5 million products here, right? It's kind of crazy. So that is the entire Simas Stamp Timber 2010. I can't even talk, you guys. It's late. I'm sorry. It's late. Simas Says Stamp Timber 2020 release. There we go. Just a reminder that all of these items that are released from the Simon brand, specifically the Simon products, these will probably be restocked if they sell out. These will, you know, the likelihood of them coming back in stock is good if they sell out. However, for the collaboration stamp sets that are collaborations with other stamp companies, those will be released like one per day or a couple per day throughout the month. Those stamp sets, when they're gone, they're gone. So if you really love some of those stamps, you gotta buy them while you can. They don't stick around. So just a heads up, some people get real sad when they realize that's not available anymore. So just letting you guys know you're gonna need to look into that. So anyway, I'm gonna look into the comments here. I want you guys to tell me what your favorite thing is, what you're ordering. You get these out of the way. Tell me what you're ordering, because I need to know. I'm so curious. Bring my laptop over here so I can actually see what I'm looking at. Okay. Yes. Lori. She's like, that's a lot of products, Christina. Thanks for doing this live. It's a lot. There were so many. I think it came in a couple boxes from Simon, and I had to email the people at the corporate office and be like, can you send me a list of everything that's in this release? Because I don't know if I've got it all. It was a lot. It was a lot. Okay. Ooh, this is a good idea. Jamie says, the ones you can build quilt backgrounds are my favorite. Yeah, the geometric builders, the circles and the squares. So fun. I love those. I can't wait to cut out pattern paper and cut out different colors of cardstock. I think it's going to be really fun. Let's see. Yes, the coffee set dies. That that latte gift card. Guys, I'm tired. I can't talk. I'm real tired. Okay. J&P Thieler says, I need a million and buy them all. Yeah, right? I feel really lucky that Simon sends them to me, because I would have a hard time paring down what I was going to buy. Okay. Pam is here. Hey, Pam. Poconut Pam. Love Poconut Pam. And she's loving my snowflakes. Thanks, Pam. I love the snowflakes too. Some of my favorites. 42 Rosie says, I really need a large hand lettered happy anniversary stamp or die. That is a very good suggestion. Thank you. I might remember that for later. Annie says, the engraved leaves looked amazing. Those die cuts. Yes, those leaves look awesome. Do you guys remember the eucalyptus leaves from a couple of releases ago? Those were really popular. Like, they sold out really quick. Everyone loved them. I think they've been restocked multiple times. People love those. Okay. The one with geometric die and stamp set, and the one I designed, You Matters. Yes, thank you. I love that. Belinda says, the sympathy set is a good set to cover the bases. Yes, that's exactly what I was going for when I did that one, because like, there are so many different occasions you need a sympathy sentiment for, and just with sympathy doesn't always work, you know, like you need something that's a little bit more specific. So awesome. Okay. Lisa's got a good list here. She says, sympathy greetings, banner greetings, all the 6x9 stencils, wood background, and so much more. You've named all really good ones. Who am I kidding? They're all good. Okay. Ewok Girl TX, Star Wars fan from Texas, maybe? I like the slimline dies with the keep shining sentiment. Thanks for previewing all this for us. Yes, I love that one. That was the marquee, the slimline marquee die set with all the dots. I love that. Let's see. Tracy says, I need the gift card die. Totally cute bow for it. Yeah, I think that bow could be put on a lot of different things, actually. It doesn't have to go on the gift card note card. It could be go on a lot of things. All right. Just hit 45 minutes. I think I'm going to close up the chat and close up the video because, like I mentioned multiple times, it is late. I'm starting to not understand words. I can't talk. So, anyway, thank you guys so much for joining me tonight for this kind of impromptu live stream. I asked you guys on Instagram and it was almost split 50-50, but a little bit more on the live. And I thought, I've never done a live like this, like late at night. Why not? In my pajamas. Hope you guys enjoyed. And thank you so much for joining me. Let's see here. Good morning from Germany. I hope you're still in your pajamas for a different reason. Morning, not evening. All right. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I will be back very soon with another card video. Wednesday morning, bright and early, I'll have a card made with some of the products that you've seen in this live stream. Have a lovely evening, you guys. If it's late where you are and you're heading to bed, sleep well, sweet dreams, and I will see you guys in another video very soon.